Okay, so it's currently 11 p.m. there you can see. So it's approximately 6 hours until I'm leaving tomorrow, until my friend brings me to the train station. And I just finished watching The Bachelor with my friends. I already packed everything, so there's my suitcase, my backpack, and the clothes I'll be wearing tomorrow. Just some tights, joggers, and a hoodie with a t-shirt underneath. Yeah, I still have to lay out the t-shirt that's in my suitcase. Okay, so I have to do that. And yeah, I'm really excited to see how it's going to be there. So I have one stop in Munich after 6 hours of driving by bus. And then it's going to be another almost 6 hours until I'm in Prague. So it's actually going to be dark, I think, when I'll be arriving, which is a bit scary. I haven't really thought of that before. But I just have to try to figure out how to get to the house. And yeah, then I'm really excited to see how that goes. To the Prague station, and I actually also made it to the bus that takes me to the village I'm supposed to go to. And it's really dark, it's 10 p.m. right now, and I have to walk like half an hour to get there. Yeah, but the city is really pretty. One man offered help, so I was completely lost. yeah, now I'm on a good way to actually make it there. Now let's hope I don't die, because then I've achieved everything I wanted for the day. Yeah, so fun story. Remember how I jokingly said I hope I wouldn't die? Yeah, so apparently those 30 minutes that I had to walk to go to the house included a walk through the woods at 10:30 p.m. in the dark in a country I've never been to before with my heavy suitcase alone. Which was quite scary, also because the walk started in front of a cemetery and Google Maps told me to go to the right, which after 5 minutes of considering whether I should really do that, I actually did. So I was walking through there alone, just to find out that I was heading towards the wrong house. But luckily the people there were really friendly and willing to help, also because apparently the houses got mixed up more frequently, so they knew where I wanted to go and they helped me. But still, it was freaking scary going through there, but somehow I managed to not die, so I'm really glad I managed to do at least that.
Oh,
so I told the people I'm staying with I wanted to go hiking a bit, and they told me I could take the goats with me. Which I thought might be a bit weird since they are so strong and maybe that would be a bit difficult. But I said, yeah, I'll do that. So now I'm out with the goats. There were actually many more, and I think almost all of them followed, but I don't know, a car came, and all of a sudden down on the street there, and all of a sudden they just all ran away while I was trying to get my phone out. So it's just the three of us and the dog. And I wasn't wrong, they are really strong. And this one, the black one, just stayed because he's horny for the brown one. He's always trying to climb on her. And I don't know how far we will go, because that way there is a bit small. I don't know if I want to go there with them. But since it's only three now, might not be that difficult. Oh, that's really pretty. Don't go down there. Oh, they are so strong. Yeah. Oh, it's really pretty up here. Right? Okay, so I just figure out what to do with the goats. I hope they all ran back home and not somewhere else. Oh no, I can see them down there. Okay, good. So I hope I didn't lose any of them. It's actually quite a big responsibility. Imagine if I lost some of them. Yeah, that would be pretty bad. Today I've decided to go on a hike in a natural reservoir, I think it is. It's called Divoka Sharka, if that's how you pronounce it. What's really cool about it is that it's like right outside of the city. Like, it's really, really close to it. It's also like 30 minutes by bus and tram from where I live, where my host lives. Yeah, it was actually supposed to be the last day without rain today, but it did rain, and now everything is kind of wet and really cloudy. But I decided to go today anyway because it's also supposed to rain the next few days, so I figured it would be best to go today because like right now it's actually not raining, it's just wet still. It's supposed to be like a really easy route, and yeah, it's also really cool. I imagine it would look a lot cooler if the sun was shining. But we have to take what we get. So, yeah, that's what it looks like here. And this is Mara. There you go. Yeah, so I'm standing here. It's really cool. And there's actually a swimming pool right there. There's also a lake at the beginning. And so, you know, and over there you can have a great look over the city. Right there. It's actually the only place where it's sunny right now. And yeah, all of that is the city. So it's like really, really close to it. Do it sometime.
sparking song.
Like a mushroom, but I'm making the goat for the last time right now. There you go. I don't know, can I put this on YouTube? I was just packing my suitcase and it took me like an hour, and when I got back down again to the living room, I don't know where the people I'm staying with went to, so I'm currently all alone right now. And also I just saw over there where the goats live that there's a baby goat, like a new one, a just born one. I'm going to go over there when I'm done milking the goat and I can take some pictures. I just saw it look so cute. Oh my god, would you look at that? What a teeny tiny baby goat. Aren't they just so sweet? Oh, they must go. They can't go out in a few hours. They're so cute. I'm sorry, not going to bother you anymore, just wanted to see them. Oh, they're so sweet. They're screaming the whole time.
Sparking song. Electrify.